This episode's FDR shoutout goes to Jude Lee. Leave a comment down below to have a chance for a shoutout in the next episode. Make sure you're subscribed.
Whoa, hey, it's Future Chris here again. Sorry for interrupting the FDR, but I just gotta make a special announcement because we just reached 1,000 users on Petscord. On Petscord. On Petscord. Yes, our little fish keeping, pet keeping community online is growing and it only goes up from here, folks. It's also the new way to submit your fish tanks for fish tank review. Hope to see you guys on there. Peace. What's up, guys? Hope you guys are doing well. Welcome back to... What? Okay, yeah, I got a haircut. Cut it myself again. Gotta save that money, you know? And there's another lockdown where I live, so... What's a guy gotta do to cut his hair? I think this is my third time cutting my own hair. I don't know. The back just looks horrendous, so let's not go there. But just like fish tanks, the back of the fish tank doesn't really matter, right? I thought if I could aquascape, I could cut hair, come on. Welcome back to Fish for Thought. You're watching Fish Tank Review. Thank you to my 150 plus patrons. What? We had like 100 patrons a few months ago. How is there 50 more of you guys? Thank you so much for the amazing support. I use every drop of that penny of investment that you have entrusted into me to continue to run this channel. If you've been considering joining the Patreon team, there are some perks for you and I would love to have you on the team. Thank you so much for your support and your consideration. Cleaning Diana Nasty Fishbowl. Dish soap? Holy crap. Happy Diana. Well, first of all, you just called your own fishbowl a nasty fishbowl thing. I hope it doesn't take a genius to realize that that fishbowl is nasty because of you. Your betta fish shouldn't be in a fishbowl to start with, nor should you wash it out with dish soap. Look, I truly don't think people are this dumb. This then just opens the other door to, you know, doing it for clout, which I actually think it's worse than just pure stupidity, because with being dumb, at least you didn't mean it. Well, I don't know. I don't want to make assumptions because this person was dumb enough to put their betta fish in a small fishbowl like this to begin with. So this fish tank is sent in by Andrew Clark. My boy straight up made a tree. That's amazing, dude. Fantastic choice with that wood piece. Such an interesting wood piece. You took full advantage of that and planted it up, attached some of these bryophytes, moss, some of the puffiest little moss balls I've ever seen. Actually, those are not Marimo moss balls, mind you. Those are actual moss that was ripped apart and individually attached, so good on you. That takes quite some skill, technique, and time. And I love the rocks as well. Seiru stone. Amazing. Good job. Understocked as well. This is getting a solid 4.65. Axel sent in this fish tank. Beautiful, clean, what looks to be a 10 gallon. Not sure what it's stocked with, but for sure it's understocked. You've got CO2. You've got a nice clearing amidst all that lush, very nice texture plants. It's beautiful. It's lacking a bit of hardscape in my opinion. Perhaps there could be some interesting pieces of branches coming out, jutting out from the back, but still very enjoyable scape. 4.6 out of 5, keep it up. You guys are going hard today, hitting me up with those lit scapes, bro. There's a shark fish, a white angelfish, and three other small black and gray striped fish. She wants $75 for everything pictured. Hope he doesn't want to throw away or flush fish, so must take it all. Okay, while I was reading it, I was imagining some super big tank, not this like 5 to 10 gallon crap fest, dirty algae outbreak, no maintenance, rainbow barf gravel crap. How is that able to house all the fish that was mentioned? And what the hell's a shark fish, you idiot? Just because you don't want to take care of this crap that you've made with barely any research and a care in the world for things that are alive, just because you don't want to take the time and effort to learn anything substantial and meaningful in your life, doesn't mean you get to threaten people on Craigslist to say, if you don't take this for $75, I'm gonna flush these fish. Because that's what they're effectively saying. They're not saying, I don't want to flush these fish. They're saying, I want to, unless someone pays me $75. Go to hell. Sell it at Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Is that blood? I don't know what kind of show Brooklyn Nine-Nine is. I'm assuming it's some like cop show detective thing. Good thing I didn't watch it because we got our masterpiece fishbowl. Why does there gotta be a fishbowl in like most movies or shows? Is it that ingrained into our society to... I mean, poor goldfish, they just can't catch a break. Someone on my Discord channel was like, yo, goldfish were the first fish they sent to space, and they figured out you can't have goldfish in space. I don't know if that's true or not, but they were saying something funny like, yo, goldfish can't, why can't they catch a break, man? They gotta be the first to be abused in every category. OP said that he was toying around with the fishes and experimenting with them. Well, do you even need to say that? I mean, just take a look at this tank. You got some clownfish and you got some angelfish. If that's not the definition of toying with your fish, I don't know what is. A picture says 1,000 words, and yeah, OP, you can keep your mouth shut. We know you're toying with your fish. You want to waste your money while playing with the lives of innocent creatures? You think it's cool and edgy to be a psychopath? You're just a little twerp with an underdeveloped brain. Julian M. sent in this fish tank, and it's quite beautiful. I love the mopani wood. Plants embedded all throughout. You make a little opening with the mopani wood, and the texture of that wood is so enjoyable. You got a single betta fish, and there's another picture. Look at this. This is a cute betta fish. Short finned, that's a plus one for me. Beautiful picture too, you got a nice depth of field macro on them. 4.15 out of 5, keep it up. 28 gallons for two discus. Two discus and actually maybe three discus. I mean, those fish are quite small right now. They're like juvenile transitioning into adults, so they still got growing to do. Not a great tank, this is quite literally too small for discus as a species, because I feel like they're more comfortable in a school of five at least. I would give more than that, and they would like a big tank with lush green plants or some branches, a lot of branches, so that they can dart in and throughout it. This tank you're looking at maybe like five guppies. That would be good for this tank. Maybe a pair of Garneri killies. You got a lot of choices. You don't have to go with discus. You're not really going to be impressing anyone. Instead, you're going to be making people mad. If you're trying to look cool for someone, this is not going to work. You're overcompensating. You're going to look like a fool instead. Someone who doesn't know how to take care of fish properly. As far as the aquascape goes, I don't even want to talk about that. This tank is sent in by Linus. Now this is an aquascape I want to talk about. Look at the bundles of lush plants. Look at the colors, the textures, and how they're filling in the height of this taller fish tank. When it's taller, it's always, like I always say, it's always a little trickier to aquascape, but this person handled it perfectly. 4.6 out of 5, keep it up.
This episode's bonus secret comment is Cory Gang.
Shrimp. Betta fish that are hungry. right in the visor area. Bam. The betta fish really know how to get to the shrimp. And let me correct this. They don't even have to be hungry, okay? Betta fish are like cats. At least my betta fish Rosé. Frickin', I thought I was doing Rosé a favor, right? I took Rosé, introduced it into my Amano shrimp and cherry shrimp tank because it was so well planted. I thought Rosé would love it in there. Yeah, she did. She did quite enjoy her experience, but all the shrimp were killed overnight. I was looking, making sure things are alright, and things were okay. She was distracted by the plants, but lo and behold, when I woke up in the morning and I opened the lights and to check on her, and I've told this story before, there's a Amano shrimp almost half the size of her own body laying there in the substrate, and she's looking at it, but then she sees me and she looks up. She starts wagging her little tail like she brought me a present. It was smack dab in the middle of the tank. She's a little piece of crap, and so are your betta fish. Never trust them. Don't take that chance. She didn't even eat any of them. She was just happy that they're dead. That's a 10-year-old Perun shark. I've never heard of that before. A 20-year-old iridescent shark, both of them bought when they were fry, and a goldfish which has apparently changed its color to silverish while in a 40-liter tank. Last water change was about 4 months back. How are they surviving for many years? Oh goodness, that is insane. 4 months back water change for this small of a tank with those huge fish, and they supposedly lived, the iridescent shark lived 20 years in this filth. I can't imagine how it smells in there. I mean, isn't that an issue? The smell emanating from your fish tank? Don't you want to do something about that? Like, do fish abusers or animal abusers not care about smell? Do they like that rotting, like, poop, disgusting ammonia smell? These fish have been through hell and back. I hope they die a peaceful death so they can be treated like the kings and queens they are up in heaven. When you tell people you have fish and they go, oh, do you have a betta? I have mine in a bowl. Oh no. Wait, is that Michael Jordan crying over Kobe's death? Okay, I mean, I don't want to use this picture, okay? No matter what, that is taking it to the next, that's too soon. Someone asking you that annoying question, do you have a betta? I have a bowl at home. That is not anywhere close to the passing of one of the greatest NBA players of all time. I get the sentiment. I just don't want anything to do with that picture. I just don't want to be reminded of that event. Now I've reminded all of you of that tragedy. This is a fish tank show, man. Why are we here just to suffer? Next time someone asks me that, I might just reply, oh, actually I have an alpha. Hey guys, welcome back to the end of the video. Thank you for staying this whole time, increasing the watch time on this video, supporting the channel. I'm so thankful for each and every one of you tuning into this series every week. I hope you have an amazing rest of the week. I hope this started your Monday off just right. The secret comment of this episode is corridores. Don't forget to look for the bonus secret comment somewhere in the middle of this video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe. There'll be more videos to come, and don't forget to get your hands wet.